As we all know, every mother counts. And in this particular case, this mother wanted her journey and the story of other mothers to be told. She has graced the covers of thousands of magazines, from Vogue to Time magazine. She's a director, yoga fanatic, entrepreneur, mother, and wife. She is the one, the only, Christy Turlington. That was just one of those moments for all of us that I think we just never forget, seeing that video. And it came from a Vogue cover with you and Tatiana and my favorite, Cindy Crawford, Linda, Naomi.
Yeah, that was a great, I mean, it was such a fun thing to do. We didn't hear the music before we got there. It was like hot off the presses, and we were all on different days except for Linda and I. And yeah, I mean, it's such a great song that actually still totally holds up.
And the video is just unbelievable.
Pretty awesome.
Ed, you got a gorgeous, handsome husband, talented, two beautiful kids. You're running a marathon. You're all over the world. What's it like for such a busy husband to have such a busy wife? And I know you can't always answer for him, but...
Yeah, well, he's really busy, too. But he tends to like to be in New York. He mostly makes films about New York, and he mostly shoots here. So he's been incredible as I've traveled the world. He's kind of the home base...
Holding down the fort.
And he's an amazing dad, and we really share our parenting responsibilities pretty equally in our household. So that's a great comfort for both of us, that we are interchangeable, and it's great to have quality time with just one of the parents around for the kids. And then it's also great to all be a family. And I don't know, our kids are seeing us be really passionate about the things that we love to do, and I think that that's like the best thing that we can do for them. So so far we're a pretty content little bunch.
You've always had such a grace and such a fragility in your movement that I think is exceptional. And I didn't realize how gorgeous your voice was really until I heard the voiceover in the movie. You just have a stunning voice. It was really, I was so moved.
The labor itself was intense, but pretty much went the way I imagined it would go. Then, in what seemed like an instant, I went from feeling invincible to powerless. The midwife called for backup. They took my baby away, and I began to hemorrhage.
The same complication that I experienced delivering a child in New York City in a birthing center in a hospital, I learned is the leading cause of maternal death in the world. Now, I imagine that maybe some women still died in childbirth, but in very rare occasions, but I actually learned that almost 500,000 women die every year from complications resulting from pregnancy or childbirth. And that was a shocking statistic.
One of the statistics I thought was fascinating, that a woman dies every 90 seconds somewhere on the planet from complications after childbirth, and that 50% of the deaths that occur from childbirth happen within 48 hours of childbirth.
Yes, that's the most dangerous time. And of those deaths, 90% of them are preventable. That's the piece that I think really excited me, was the idea that, you know, there's not a lot of issues you can say that about, but it means that almost all of the deaths are preventable.
Yeah.
And most of them from very simple solutions.
A ride to the hospital.
An educated health worker at the side of a woman. There are women who give birth by themselves. And that's all well and good if everything's okay, but it's certainly not the best first entrance into the world for the child. And for the mom, I mean, the risk of infection is very significant.
I just found it staggering when you sat and watched. It must be heartbreaking to be there. You must want to, like, buy a van for every country you went to, because you focused on four different countries in Tanzania,
Bangladesh, Guatemala, and here in the U.S. I mean, we were shocked probably mostly by the lack of transport, because in three of the countries we filmed in, health services are free, but that doesn't mean anything, because if a woman can't get to them, you know, what does it matter?
Well, I love the one story where she walked 5 miles to the hospital, then went back, and then...
Yes, Janet in Tanzania, she walks and she walks and she walks. And her story was so compelling because she was there pregnant with her third child, which most people would say, oh, she's done it a few times, it's going to be pretty straightforward, it'll probably be fast. In her case, she still had a prolonged labor, and so she was a real candidate for an obstructed labor, which could result in an obstetric fistula, which is the short film that I have here actually tonight at LunaFest. You know, we just kept coming across those stories, and the fact that we could intervene, I mean, I had no problems saying, like, when it got serious, like, please, can we give you a ride? And exactly. In some cases, the women were going home, and they had no intention to come back to get care. So we, you know, we organized transport. If we didn't take them ourselves, we provided it. And the sad thing was, the day that you leave, of course, what happens then?
Well, that's the point of every mother counts. And it's a five-year program basically about creating awareness. How can people contribute? How can people get involved?
My website, everymothercounts.org, really is a tool to further educate people, but also to provide actions that they can take. And there are some of them very simple. I mean, the thing I like to say the most is to just use your voice.